Hello children, let me welcome you to the Virtual Training Center of the Brihan Mumbai Mahanagar Palika. My name is Shraddha teacher. Children, we are in the middle of the COVID-19 pandemic, isn't it? Because of that, we are not able to go to school. But that doesn't mean that we are going to stop learning. We are going to meet here regularly through the Virtual Training Center to learn many lessons in EVS. So come on, let's go to a lesson in EVS. So children, let us continue the lesson that we started last time in standard third EVS. So do you remember which was the lesson we were doing last time? Yes, it was lesson number 19 from your EVS textbook, and the name of the lesson was My School. So in the lesson last time children, we did an introduction about our school. We talked about the types of schools that are there. We also talked about the various places in our school. That is, we have the library and we have the laboratory and we have so many different places where we go and we can enjoy ourselves also, and we can learn a lot of new things also. Okay, and in that time when we were doing that video, I told you that this is a long lesson and we will have to learn many more points in this lesson. So I will definitely come back and do one more video with you. So here I am with part 2 of the lesson, My School. So let us start by doing a quick recap of what we learned last time. So we saw this beautiful school building in the beginning, and we discussed that not all schools are this big. Some schools are huge, some schools are small. Schools in villages especially, they are made up of sometimes thatched roof. Okay, we also have schools even in today's times where children along with their teachers sit out in the open and learn so many things. But then we also discussed that whatever type of school we go to, whether it is a big school, whether it is a small school, whether it is a pakka building or otherwise, we love our schools. Why? Because the school is our second home, isn't it? After our homes, which is the place that we spent the maximum time of our day here, it is the school. That is why we love our school just like we love our homes. Okay? But unfortunately, we also discussed that because of the special situation that we are in, because of the COVID-19 pandemic, we are not able to go to school for a long time now. But that will change very soon. Okay? Very soon, all of us will go back to our schools. So let us do a recap now again and talk about the various places in our school. So see, this is a small school building. The previous one that we saw was a large school building. Now this is a small school where there is a single storied structure. Okay, and then you have the library, you have the assembly hall, you have the computer lab, the playground, school buses also. Then the counselor is there. Counselor is a person, when you have any kind of a problem, you go and talk to the counselor. Then there is a first aid facility in the school, and also there is places where we can keep ourselves clean. We can take care of our personal hygiene also in the school. You have toilets, you have water rooms. Okay, so these are all the places in the school that we talked about last time when we did the first video on this particular lesson. Now, we also learned that whatever the type of school that we go to, whether it is a big school, whether it is a small school, we learn basic reading, writing and arithmetic when we go to school. So you learn how to read, you learn how to write, and you also learn to do basic things and operations in mathematics. So this is what we learn when we go to school, isn't it? No matter whether our school is big or small. So all these things we have learned last time children, and we stopped at a stage where we talked about the right to education, and we discussed about the ancient type of schools also. Do you remember? We discussed that the kings and the rajas and the princes, they used to send their children to the gurukuls to learn. That is, a teacher used to be there in the gurukul, and these students used to go and spend time with the teacher. And all their education they used to get from the Gurukul. And they could not come back home, okay, until and unless the education was complete. We also saw there that apart from learning the mathematics, apart from learning to read, apart from learning to write, they also learned about religion, and they also learned all the household work. They had to do all kinds of household work in the school. When we did that part of the lesson, we also discussed that the girls were not allowed to go to school. Okay, we discussed that only the boys could go to school in those times. But then very soon, our government came up with this thing called as the Right to Education Act, where under the Right to Education, all the children who are in the school going age could go to school. So that was a major change which happened in our country, the Right to Education Act. So whether the children are living in villages, whether they are poor, whether they are rich, whether they live in cities, all of them have the right to attend school. So that was the Right to Education Act. So see here, these two children are from a village and these two children are from a city. They do not have any kind of uniform. They have a uniform, but they are not as well dressed as these two children. But nevertheless, all of them will be able to learn because that is their right. Okay, so we learned about these things. So what is the right to education say? The right to education says that you have the right to go to school. This right was denied. It was not given to many people in the ancient times. So people who were not from the family of kings, people who were not Brahmins, or people who did not belong to a particular caste, they could not go to school. But that is not the case today. Okay, according to the right to education, all the children have the right to go to school and learn and improve their lives. Okay, then let us take a short or small look at the Right to Education Act. So everyone has got the right to free and compulsory admission. So all of us can go to a particular school. If you want to go to a particular school, you can go there and you can ask them to give you admission there. They cannot deny you the admission. And there is a right to attend a school also. Okay, they cannot tell you, don't come here. You're not supposed to come here. Don't come here. They cannot say that. And also you can attend and you can complete your education in a neighborhood school. School which is very close to your house. Children from the age of 6 to 18 years have the right to, 6 to 14 years have the right to attend school. And those who are children with special needs, from 6 to 18 years also they can go to school. And schools are not supposed to charge fees from children. So schools which are run by government, they are not supposed to charge fees from the children. So all these are parts of the Right to Education Act, which has opened up schools to everyone in our country. So whether you are a boy, whether you are a girl, whether you are living in a village, in a city, whether you are rich, whether you are not, all of us have the right to go to a school, attend the school, complete our education and come out as educated people. Okay, there were many people who were responsible for this. This did not happen very easily. Okay, so there were some people who were responsible for it. We also saw that the British people introduced the current education system. Remember last video, if you don't remember certain points, you can always go back and watch the last video again. So in the last video, we discussed that it was the British people who introduced the present school system. In the same way, it was Mahatma Jyotirao Phule and Kranti Jyoti Savitribai Phule who began, who took a step in order to educate girls. So they began a school for girls in Pune in Maharashtra. So all the girls, all the women who are educated today are supposed to be thankful to these two people. They were the ones who took the first step in order to educate girls or women. Okay. Then we talked about, we saw great people like Rajarshi Shahu Maharaj also. He was a king. Nevertheless, he took a lot of efforts. He took a lot of concrete steps so that education is not denied to the people in his community. All right. Then you have Rabindranath Tagore. You will learn many poems about Rabindranath Tagore. Next year when you go to Standard 4th, you will learn a beautiful poem by Rabindranath Tagore called The Champa Flower. So he has written so many beautiful poems. He has started a school also called the Shanti Niketan. Okay, I'll show you a picture of the Shanti Niketan also. And even our national anthem was written by him. So all these people are the people who have taken great efforts in the field of education and in the field of schools. They have taken great pains so that education reaches everyone in society. See, this is a picture of Shanti Niketan. So Shanti Niketan is almost like the Gurukul system. Almost. But here you will see that girls are also studying. Okay, you sit out in the open, in natural surroundings, and you take education. So, such big steps and such path-breaking steps were taken by these people in order to see to it the people in India are educated. Because many of us, we were stuck in the old customs and traditions, and we never used to send the girls to school. Okay, and many people from many communities also did not want to go to school or were not allowed to go to school. But these few people, they brought about all these changes. And then you also have Mahatma Gandhi, who was the father of the nation. He also had a very, very important role in promoting education. So see, what did he say about education? By education, he said, I mean an all-round drawing of the best in the child and man in body, mind and spirit. So he said, you're not only supposed to educate your body or your mind, but you're also supposed to educate your soul or your spirit. So along with learning about maths, along with learning about science and English, you should also learn things which will make you a better human being and a good citizen. Okay. Then this was India's first education minister. All right. And he was also a person, we celebrate his birthday even now. Okay, so Maulana Azad, he was the first education minister of independent India. He was the person who appointed the University Education Commission and the Secondary Education Commission. So on the 11th of November, we celebrate his birthday as the National Education Day. And he also was the person who believed that science and technology must become a very, very important part of our curriculum. So along with knowing English, we should also know about the developments in the field of science and technology. So this is Maulana Azad for you, the first education minister of independent India. Okay, and like I told you, we celebrate his birthday, that is 11th of November, as the National Education Day. So along with Mahatma Gandhi, he also felt that education is very, very important. Okay. Then in the textbook, you will find pictures of all these people. See, Mahatma Jyotirao Phule, whom we talked about, Savitri Bai Phule. Then you have Maharaja Sayajirao Gaikwad, who also had a very, very lion's share, you can say, in the contribution towards education in our country. Rajashree Shahu Maharaj, Pandita Ramabai, all these people, you will see that they had a lot of contribution to the field of education. Now, I have told you about some of them. Now, what is your assignment or homework? You will search in the net and find out information about the other people on this image. That is, we talked about Mahatma Jyotirao Phule. We talked about Savitri Bai Phule. We talked about Rajashree Shahu Maharaj. So, now, what is your job? Try to find out more information about Pandita Ramabai, about Maharshi Dondo Keshav Karve. See what contribution they have made to the field of education. So that is your assignment here. All right. So let's move on. And now let us talk about some rules for the school. So in the first part of this lesson, we talked about what are the steps which were taken by people to set up these schools that we see today. Okay. Once upon a time in the ancient times, these schools were not accessible to all of us. All of us could not go to schools. But there were all these important people, these great people who made sure that we can all go to school like we are doing today. So now when you go to a school also, there are certain rules and regulations which should be followed. See, rules and regulations are followed in places. All the times it is not written. In your house also, in your home also, you must be having certain kind of rules. Isn't it? You respect your elders and you help your mummy in the housework. And when you're sitting down to have your meals, that is when you're sitting to have your lunch, your dinner, your breakfast, you do not watch TV, you do not play on the phone. So these are certain rules that you have at home. In the same way, we have certain rules for the school also. In case you do not have rules, life will become a very big confusion. So to live life properly, we are supposed to have rules. So in the school also, children, we have certain rules, which are of course not written. Okay, most of the time, most of these rules are not written. They are to be understood and followed. So let us see what are the rules in the school. So the first and most important rule in the school, you're going there, you're spending 5, 6, 7 hours in the school. So what should you do? You should try to keep your classroom and the surrounding clean. Then you will say, oh, there are peons for it. The peon auntie is there. The peon uncle is there. He will do it. Of course, they will do it. But it is your job also to see that you do not litter. That is, you do not contribute to the rubbish or to the garbage. So when you sharpen your pencils, collect the files and put it in the dustbin. Do not tear your book and throw the pages here and there. So these are the rules that you're supposed to follow. See, these children, they are trying. They're such tiny children, isn't it? Tiny tots. I think they might be in nursery, but they are trying to keep their classroom clean, which is very good, because Mahatma Gandhi had also talked about dignity of labor and learning by doing. You can check your textbook, children, on page number 114. You will find all these things written. All right. So Mahatma Gandhi said, talked about dignity of labor in the sense he meant that he said that all kinds of work, they are dignified. So you should respect all the people. Doesn't matter what kind of work they are doing, but they are supposed to be respected. Okay. And he also talked about learning by doing. So when you clean your classroom, when you sweep your classroom one day, you will know that it takes a lot of effort to do it. So then you will not make it dirty. Okay. So these are the things that we should learn from the people who have taught us so many things in life. You should always stand in queues. Whenever you have to go to drink water, whenever your teacher takes you to the playground to play, okay, whenever you go to receive something, you should always stand in queues and not push each other and create a big commotion. When you're taking the stairs, when you're climbing the stairs, when you're coming down the stairs, do not form a crowd, do not run, do not push. Otherwise, what will happen? Someone will fall and then there will be an injury. Okay, so these are certain simple rules that you have to follow. Even in your class, when you want to say something to your teacher, what will you do? Jump up and start speaking? No, you should raise your hand. Okay, and you should wait for your chance. Your teacher will definitely ask you and definitely try to clear your doubt. So these are all the things that you should keep in mind when you are in school. So these are, in one way or the other, the rules that are to be followed when you are in school. Sometimes we make use of these sports equipment which are there in the school. For example, you want to go out and play on the ground. Your teacher gives you a football to play with. She gives you a cricket bat and ball and stumps to play with. After you finish playing, what are you supposed to do? Keep it back where you took it from. So see to it that you use the things of your school in a good manner. Sometimes we go to the library also. From there, the teacher gives us certain books. Do not tear them. Handle them with care. Okay, because it is the property of the school, means it is your own property, because the school is also yours. So these are the things that you should remain and keep in mind. One very important thing here, you should, along with following the rules, you should also see to it that you do not fight with each other, or you do not create problems in the school. You should see to it that your behavior doesn't affect others. So don't fight with your friend. If you have some kind of difference of opinion, you can talk it out. You talk to your friend, make your friend understand, but do not get into physical fights with your friends. Okay? Sometimes when you want to take one book, maybe your friend also wants the same book. So what can you do? You can tell your friend, okay, you read the book first and then you give it to me, instead of pulling the book and fighting with each other and creating a big mess. Also, you should never make fun of others. Sometimes we make a group and we make fun of one child. When the child is alone, then that time what we do is we make fun of this child. You should never let it happen. And even if two of your friends are quarreling, they're fighting with each other, you should always try to make them friends again. Okay? You should try to take the fight to the teacher and you should try to resolve it. Resolve it means you should try to solve the problem between two of your friends instead of creating problems. So if you do all these things, if you follow all these small rules when you are inside the school, your life in school will become very good and then your school will also become a very, very good school. Okay? And of course, when you're in the library, when you're in the classroom, when others are studying, you should maintain absolute silence. Don't jump around. If the teacher is not there in the class, don't make noise. Someone must be doing their homework. Let them do it. All right? So, if you observe all these rules, like I told you, you will become good children. Okay? So, this was about the school. Now, you also have certain community services that you do in the school. Sometimes your teacher takes you outside and you do certain community services. Like you do some work in the neighborhood. But that is mostly for children who are elder. Okay? For bigger children. For smaller children like you, you can do a lot of work in the school itself. Okay? See? The children who are in the higher class, that is bigger children in your school, they must be going and trying to clean the neighborhood also. So these are all the community things that we learn from school. You might not do it yourself, but when you see your friends going out and cleaning the neighborhood, then you also learn that you also have to do it. Okay? So you learn community services also in school. Now we'll come to a very, very, you can say, important point or a very, very sad situation sometimes in our country. You can see two pictures over here. In the first picture, you can see a boy selling garlands at a traffic signal. Look carefully at the picture. You can see some children who are performing some tricks also behind in front of the signal. Okay. Now, this is an image from your textbook only, children. If you look at your textbook, you will be able to see this particular image. So, in this case, what do you understand by looking at this image? What comes to your mind? That these people, when they are supposed to go to school, what are they doing? They are doing some kind of work. Okay? They are selling garlands and they are doing some kind of tricks. Why do they do this? Why do you think they are doing this? They must be doing this in order to earn money. Alright? They must be doing this so that they earn some money. But is this their age, children, to earn money? They are supposed to go to school and study like you are doing. Okay. Look at the next picture. You will see a boy picking up bricks and handing it over to someone. That means this boy is working at a place where construction is going on. That is, people are building something. A house or a building or something like that. Now, even this child is small. He also should be going to school. But unfortunately, instead of going to school, he's doing this work here. The work of labor. Okay? So, is this allowed, children? What do you think? Are these children supposed to work in such places? Or are they supposed to go to school? Now, we just discussed that from the age of 6 to 14, you are supposed to go to school only. Then what are these people doing outside? Now, this is called as child labor. And child labor is illegal. Illegal in the sense it is not allowed. If someone catches these people who are making these children do this work, they will be sent to jail. So child labor is an illegal act. So whenever you see such things happening, you should immediately report such things. See this boy and this girl. They are also so small, isn't it? It is not their age where they should work. It is the age where they should go to school and study. But unfortunately, these poor kids are having to work. Alright? So, these are the things we should try to avoid. We should try to see that children get an opportunity to go to school. Okay? And that is why we should try to see that we report child labor whenever possible. Sometimes children are made to work in these dangerous places also. For example, they are made to work in factories where firecrackers, patake we say, no, patake, they are manufactured. So just imagine, this is so dangerous, such a dangerous place for children to work in. Okay, if there is a small spark, this entire place will blow up. And these poor children, they will lose their lives. So there are certain places where they are not allowed at all. But otherwise also, in 2006, there was a new rule or a new law which says that all kinds of child labor is illegal. So now it doesn't matter whether you're working in a factory or whether you're working in a canteen or at the dhaba. No child is supposed to work. They are all supposed to go to school. So that is a new law. So we should say no to child labor. All right. So these were the things that we learnt in the second part of the lesson, children. We learnt about the various people who have worked really very hard in order to improve the situation of education in our country. Okay, previously, like I said, we were following the system where all people could not go to school, and then we had the British who came to India and they introduced the modern system of education. Why did they do that? They did that because their own mother tongue was English and they wanted the people in India also to know English so that they could help them in their work. Alright, then we had Savitribai Phule and Jyotiba Phule who went and promoted girls' education. That is, they were not, girls were not allowed to go to school at all. Schools were opened up but only for boys. But then how they fought the situation and how today we all, girls, boys, every one of us can go to school. And then we also had the Right to Education Act, because of which, again, all of us between the age of 6 to 14 could go to school. And then we also talked about a very serious problem in our country, that is child labor, and how we should put an end to it. Okay, so that was part 2 of the lesson, number 19, My School. So children, wasn't that a very interesting lesson? I'm sure you learnt a lot of new things in this lesson. If you have liked this video, please hit the like button and also subscribe to my video so that you will get to see all the videos which I keep posting regularly.